Jeremiah for Simple Snippets, and I'm back with another video tutorial on C++ programming. So in this video tutorial, we'll see the concept of arrays and what exactly arrays are. So let's get started. So before we understand what is an array, consider a scenario wherein your program needs 100 different variables to store 100 different values. So in that case, you'll have to create a variable every time and give it a name. So in order to name 100 different variables, you need 100 values, right? So that would be a tedious job. So an array is a series of elements of the same type placed in contiguous memory location that can be individually referenced by adding an index to unique identifier. Well, that seemed like a pretty complex definition. So let's break that into parts. So the first line says an array is a series of elements. So by elements, I mean series of variables of the same type. Now type here means that it is data type. So an array will have same data type for all the variables that it will store. And it is placed in contiguous memory location. Contiguous means right next to each other. So your computer memory has different addresses. So the address allotted to this array would be in series. So I'll explain you what it means in a while. And the individual variables inside the array can be referenced by adding an index. And the index usually starts from 0. So here's an example. You can see int arr. So the int is the data type of the array. The arr is the name of the array. And inside the square brackets, you can see 5, which is the size of the array. This means that it will store 5 different variables of integer data type. And as you can see, I have assigned them in the curly braces, that is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So at 0th position, we have the value of 10. At the first, we have 20, so on and so forth. So have a look at this table. The first row is the memory location. Now in the computer memory, in your RAM, consider the memory location starting from 0, that is the address of the memory location, that is starting from 0 till 9. And this 0 is 1 byte, then we have another byte at starting at position 1. So that is just the address. Now since the array is going to store all the variables in the contiguous memory location, and consider that integer variable takes up 2 bytes, so 0 and 1 byte would be taken by the first variable, which is at the 0th position, that is the index, which is at the second row, and the value stored is 10. Similarly, the second and third position, or the second and third address, is going to be taken by the second variable, and it can be referenced by the index 1, and the value stored is 20. So let me just show you a quick demo or a sort of representation of the memory and how the value is going to be stored, and then you'll understand what contiguous memory location means. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, we have an integer typed array. The data type is int, so that it will store only integer values. The name is arr and the size here is 3. So it will store 3 variables of integer data type, and as you can see, I have allotted 1, 2 and 3 already assigned. Now consider this as the computer memory, which I have drawn in tabular form, and this one block to be 1 byte. So we have the first byte, second byte, third byte, fourth byte, and so on and so forth. Now considering that 2 bytes of memory can store one variable, integer variable, so suppose the address of this memory location is 00001, and again we have 0002, so on and so forth. So contiguous means in sequence. So the first variable inside the array, that is this, would be stored in this block. The second variable, that is 2, would be stored right next to the first one. And the third one would again be stored right besides the second one. So this is what contiguous memory location means. Now let's go ahead and see a program wherein we'll create an array and we'll try to take input as well as show the output. So quickly go ahead and open up your IDE. So I've just typed in the structure, that is the basic structure which has the include IOStream line, then we are using namespace standard. Again, the int main function, which is the starting point of the program. And we are going to see array initialization, array traversing, taking input into array, and printing the array output. So here's how we create an array. This is the data type. This is the array name. We have to give the size in advance, that is before running the program, because it is statically allocated. That is, you cannot give the size at runtime. We'll understand the dynamic memory allocation in further tutorials, but right now we'll statically give the size beforehand. And I have directly initialized the values as well. Now another declaration can be double ARR1. I've given the size, but in this case I have not allotted values, so I can separately allot values as well. So for 0th position I can say 1.456. then for the next position I can say 36.765. since it is a double array, that is it will store double values, so I can have floating point variables as well. So this was one way of declaring of a array. Now we can have a character array as well. Okay, so how do you take input from user for an array? Now since we know that the variables can be accessed via the index position starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on and so forth, we can use a for loop to iterate through all these positions. So let me just create a new array. I'll say int temp array and I'll say its size 5, and I'll take the input from user. I'll say enter 5 integer variables. Now I'll say for int I equals to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So this loop will run 5 times, and I'll take the array input for 5 times. Now notice that I gave the index as I. So for every time or every iteration inside this loop, this I value will be incremented and it will run till 5 iterations. So the index would be incremented till 4. So I'll take from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 5 values, and those will be inputted into the array. So what if I want to see what is been inputted? So again I'll use the same logic. I'll use the for loop, and this time instead of C in, I'll write C out, and the name has to be temp underscore ARR and not ARR. And again inside the square brackets I'll write I, and just to create or print it on a new line I'll say end L. So let's see how this goes. I'll compile and run this program. Okay, so as you can see it's asking me for 5 values. I'll say 1, let's click enter, 2, enter, 3, enter, 4, enter and 5. So as you can see it printed again the next or the array values as well. So you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 printed again. Let me just go ahead and print a message. The values you entered are. One thing to remember is that array index always starts from 0. So you cannot start the array index from 1, or you cannot say for I equals to 1, because it will miss out on the 0th value. So that is the reason why I started from I equals to 0, and I iterated till I equals to 4, because in this condition you can see I is less than 5 means till I goes to 4. Now if you count from 0 to 4, you'll count 5 different values, and that is the size exactly of our temp array that we just created. So always remember array index starts from 0. Okay, let's go ahead and run this once again. Okay, again it's asking me for 5 integer values. I'll say 34 space 56 space 23 22 and 1. Okay, so there you go with the message. The values you entered are 34 56 23 22 and 1. So that's how you take input, print output, as well as traverse in the array. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you understood the concepts of array and why they are used, some of its properties, and how to go about programming, how to declare and initialize an array, how to take input, print output. So in further tutorials, we'll see and perform different operations on arrays as well. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Peace.